aboard Monorail Silver of the Walt Disney World Transportation System. Our next scheduled stop will be the Magic Kingdom Station. Please remain seated. I also refrain from smoking as we're traveling to our destination. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the next stop will be the Magic Kingdom Station. As you're exiting, please take small soda friendly by the hand, lower your head, and watch your step. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Magic Kingdom Station.
Please step carefully out to the moving platform. Then step into the vehicle and remain seated throughout your journey. Please stay clear of the doors. They open and close automatically. Please step carefully. Carefully out to the moving platform. Then step into the vehicle and remain seated throughout your journey.
Lloyd at your service. Very programmed to be your guide on this people mover tour of tomorrow. You might say I'm sort of a commuter computer. Have you noticed this one-way people mover car doesn't have an engine? Well, you see, these vehicles travel quietly and with no air pollution on a system of linear induction motors. That's kind of a fancy term for the special electromagnets that push and pull our vehicles around Tomorrowland. There are more than 600 of these electromagnets that bend along our railway track.
Right.
Blast off the actual close-up Someday, systems like the White
House will be developed
for your eyes. They can be used for transportation inside buildings. On this could lead to new concepts and
systems. Like Space Mountain.
There's just such an idea for a model city of the future. The tallest building would combine living, working, and shopping areas into a central location. There's even an airport and an amusement park. For a more earthbound race, just follow the
whole
way to the
Grand Prix
Raceway. But watch out, there's no other checkpoint to the driving pipe. Better look at Space Mountain. Impressive, isn't it?
40 miles per hour. But we decided to save high-speed adventures like that for space melt, so we're just cruising along at 10 miles per hour.
And Beth and Daddy are back there, too. They're way back there. No bumping!
Okay, and I...
Thank you.
covered.
Help!
some people went on this.
Yeah.
There's a racing cars.
Oh, no, Scott, take a look. Take the mod. Mod's right over there.
yet.
Yeah.
been 1.5 weeks in the jungle. Every part of civilization, we enter the Amazon River region of South America. For less than rare plants grown abundant, this is also a tropical rainforest where it rains 365 days a year. Most interested about these plants, I'll tell you, they do not require any food for them to grow. They get their nourishment strictly from the moisture in the air. Our launch is Inspiration Fall, solely named because it inspires us to go deeper and deeper and deeper into the jungle. Are we inspired today, Krill? Yeah, must have been that great lunch you had. Doesn't surprise me one bit. But I'm so glad that the people on my left are not inspired because these are carnivorous vines. And it just so happens that these vines like to come down and whisk people from the left-hand side of the boat right out. We have no idea where you go because we never see you again. Sorry sight. Continuing on to the Congo River of Africa, we see war canoes of a local pygmy tribe. Translate those down for you. We are sorry we cannot come out to greet you, but we would love to have you all for dinner. Take a look straight ahead. That is the giant python, though. Be careful if you lean on it. He leans in. He'll give you the Okongo squeeze, guaranteed to leave you breathless. To your right is a safari camp. Uh-oh. Lucky. Uninvited house guests. Look at the way they park the jeep. Looks like monkey business comes natural to these guys. If you look straight ahead, you'll notice the long, sloping forehead, the enormous ears, and huge white tusks. Why are you still looking at me? I'm not talking about me, I'm talking about the elephant. That is known as the African bull elephant. The African bull elephant is afraid of only one animal in the jungle, and one animal only. And we have it right here for you. Take a look around the corner to your right. There she is, folks. His mate. Continuing on to the animals of the African plain. These animals come down to the river to feed and to drink. Those tidal lions have just made a fresh kill. And the vultures, well, they're waiting for their turn. This little snitch may go out of the jungle. Survival of the fittest. Look at those dancing natives. Have you ever seen anyone dance without any music before? Look at that. Isn't that terrific? Wow. All of a sudden, they're dancing because of a rifle. If I remember correctly, the last time they attacked from this side, they're attacking from the left. Men, sit down. Women, children, please stand up.
Thank you. Welcome aboard the Nautilus. My name is Artie, and I'll be your host and helmsman on a voyage 20,000 leagues under the sea. Captain Nemo will be joining us shortly. For your own safety, you request that you refrain from any eating, drinking, smoking, or flash photography. The porthole window directly in front of you is highly reflective, and any flash would bounce back into the camera, and the photo would not develop properly. So if you like taking photos, we suggest you do so without a flash. Also, if you'd please remain seated as well. We're heading on our way out to sea to dive, and at that time, I'll hand control over Captain Nemo. Here we go, crew, so just sit back, relax, and enjoy the voyage.
Stand by to dive.
Diving stations.
Dive! Dive!
And now we can see the
pilot. Trim bow diving planes. 3 degrees down.
Catch for a dead paddle.
Aye, aye.
This is Captain Nemo speaking. Welcome aboard the Nautilus. We are proceeding on a course that will take us on a voyage 20,000 leagues under the sea. En route, we will pass beneath the polar ice cap and then probe depths seldom seen by man. So make yourselves comfortable. But please, remain seated at all times. Here among the reefs, you will see many familiar inhabitants of the undersea world. The great green sea turtles, for instance, are the reptilian patriarchs of the deep. These amphibious descendants of the dinosaur have changed little in the past 200 million years. Groupers, or giant sea bass, roam the coastal bottoms in search of food. Is quite safe from such marine predators. The fish world has always been considered a silent habitat, but with our sonar hydrophones, we have discovered that fish actually talk. Listen. Satellite ships. They are harvesting the abundance that nature has sown here beneath the sea. Kelp beds are cultivated, sea creatures corralled and protected from predators, just as terrestrial shepherds protect their flocks from ravenous wolves.
Degrees down. Hold her at 80 fathoms
then proceed on course. Nautilus can dive safely below the violence of ocean storms. Surface vessels are not so fortunate. Witness the evidence of their fate. The graveyard of lost ships. For ages, these rotting holes have kept their secret treasures, safeguarded by silent sentinels of the deep. Man-eating sharks, nature's most unpredictable predators of the sea. Some scholars theorize that a remarkable civilization was destroyed by a tremendous volcano. Others treat any concept of Atlantis as pure fantasy, along with legends of sea serpents and mermaids.
Begging your pardon, sir, but did you say sea serpents are mere fantasies?
Be they there, mate. Anyone in his right mind knows there's no such thing as a sea serpent or mermaids. Mr. Baxter, if you think you're seeing mermaids and sea monsters, you've been submerged too long.
Steady as she goes.
Mars. Its hull has been crushed like an eggshell.
Another monster is attacking forward, sir.
Full repellent charge. Repellent charge, aye aye. Maximum voltage. All ahead. All ahead, aye aye. Hold that, sir. Help. Maneuver. All engines, stand by to surface.
Aye, aye.
Surface!
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 The Graves Volcano, sir.
Proceed on course.
All ahead.
All ahead, aye, aye.
Station the maneuvering watch.
Aye, aye, sir. All hands to stations.
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments we will be docking at Vulcania, our home port. It has been a pleasure having you aboard the Nautilus on this memorable voyage that has taken us 20,000 leagues under the sea. Captain to bridge. Reduce speed and proceed to number 4 berth. Stand by to dock.
Bridge, aye aye. All in, 1 berth. Stand by the mooring.
Thank you for sailing with us. And now, when the cabin lights come on, please stand by to disembark. Gather your belongings, take small children by the hand, and watch your step.
Okay, crew have now reached our home port and are docking momentarily. When we do, we ask that you please remain seated. Please remain seated until the white cabin lights come on and the all ashore signal has been given.
The air is smoking.
Get me on the camera.
How do you do it now? How do you press it?
Oh,
just go? Okay.
Beth again. She's over there. How did she do that? Mom, you have the camera. Oh, no, the camera. Get over there and get him with the family.
It's on by itself?
It's on by itself?
I don't know. That's what he said.
Scott.
Where's the zoom on that, Scott?
Can I use it? Dad, I want to use it. Dad.
It says battery or something.
One charge. Dad.
It says battery's
dead. That's because it's dead. The battery's dead.